Okay, as you can see, I've got four beautifully vibrant colors for my Play-Doh. Now it's time for the cooking part, which means ask a parent or guardian to supervise or help you because it can get a bit hot and heat can be dangerous sometimes. Let's do this. Okay, so I'm using a hot plate today. I've never actually used anything else to make Play-Doh, so I don't know if you can do it on the stove, but either way, you're gonna need a parent or guardian to help you. Now, according to my mum, who is the Play-Doh queen, what you need to do is keep it on a low heat and continuously keep mixing in order to avoid lumps from forming. I'm gonna start. It's cooking already. So as you can see, it gets less and less liquidy in a really short period of time. And what you want to do is you want to take it off the hot plate, give it a couple of seconds, maybe a couple of minutes to cool down, and then you just want to mush it around a bit, make it into a ball so it's all together in one form. All together as one. I think some of my colors are going to mix together because I'm leaving it on the hot plate, the old bits, but I don't think there's anything wrong with that. We'll just have some interesting colors. This is not as easy as it looks. I reckon my yellow is going to turn into some snotty, greeny colour, which I'm totally fine with. I love the flecks of green in my yellow. One of a kind. I wonder if my blue is going to turn purple from the red of my overly pinked pink Play-Doh. That would be pretty cool. Now, I don't know how I've done it. By a total fluke, I've managed to get three different colors of blue Play-Doh. So essentially, I've made rainbow Play-Doh, totally by accident. Now, you can see in my hot plate, it is messy. And this mess is my mess. I wanted to make Play-Doh and I made a mess. So now I have to clean it up. Okay, so this is the last bit that we're doing in the making of our Play-Doh. And again, this bit is optional. I love having sparkly Play-Doh. It's really fun to play with and you can make lots of little things with it. So in order to do that, I've got biodegradable glitter. And the reason I'm using biodegradable glitter is because we want to reduce our waste. And basically this way, if you've got a composter at home, you can throw your Play-Doh in the composter. check out my glittery morsels of fun. The best thing about Play-Doh is you can make absolutely anything. You don't even have to make anything related to anatomy, but what I've found is that the best way to learn something is to use as many senses as possible to try and understand. So with Play-Doh in particular, you're using sight, you're using touch, and you're also using smell. It definitely has a certain smell to it. And when you combine all these senses together to understand something and to remember something, you're far more likely to remember it later down the track. Now, time to make some stuff. Let me show you what I've been up to. If you've had a go at this craft, send me some photos of your creations because I would love to see what you've come up with. Bows also provide us with very important protection. Think about how essential your brain, heart, and internal organs are. How lucky are we that we have a cage around our heart and lungs and a vault housing our brain? But here's where bones are really amazing, you see, because even though we kind of picture them as these hard, solid objects, they are actually so much more than that.
I'll say.
Bones act as storage centers for important minerals such as calcium and phosphorus. These minerals are necessary for a whole range of different chemical reactions all over our body. They are stored in our bones and then released into the bloodstream as ions and distributed wherever they need to go. Now, we've all seen blood, right? Have you ever skimmed your knee or had a blood nose? You've seen the red stuff that can leak out. Blood is pumped all over our bodies. But did you know that the cells which form our blood come from our bone marrow, which is inside our bones? This includes red blood cells, which carry oxygen around our bodies, but also white blood cells, which help our immune system to protect us from things that make us sick. So on the inside, our bones aren't actually as solid as they seem. That's why the outside of our bones are called compact bone, and the inside is called spongy bone. But even compact bone is riddled with passageways housing blood vessels, lymphatic vessels, and nerves. In fact, the deeper you delve into a long bone, you will find a space where there is no bone tissue at all. Instead, there's a cavity which houses the yellow bone marrow. Gee whiz, our bones are hard workers. They do a lot of stuff. Luckily, the adult human skeleton has 206 bones to share the workload. And if you can believe it, after all that, there is still a lot more to learn about bones. So stay tuned for more episodes in the series. Hooroo!